telco can go forward, but I cannot lead that life of a gated community to a gated where I'm personally seeing my own bank account. It just doesn't feel good to me in many ways.
Hello, sir. My name is Rohit Mohan. I wanted to ask you, sir, there is a lot of scope for research and development in India, and don't you think that it is very important for the government to step up, actually to start investing in research and development, and actually the youth should take up this issue to the government so that they start investing in research and development so that they can find more alternative forms of energy, such as like Brazilians did with the biodiesel?
You know, I mean, Arvind Kejriwal was my college mate for 3 years. And I thought I will tell him to take this desk as the next dharna of what it should be, right? But the issue is, I would say that, see, the research and development, especially in this field, is, yes, the technology research and development have to be done to a certain extent, but the world has become so small in terms of the internet. I really, today it's not the question about, if you travel, the poor in Sri Lanka, the poor in India, poor in Africa, except that you're supporting a cricket team with a national flag, the other issues are the same. The lack of electricity, water. I think that research and development, there are a lot of existing technologies that are good enough for today's implementation. The research and development of our strength as a country is business models. And there, I think that if the youth can actually push towards different business models and different social enterprises, automatically you have the other section of youth, in fact, trying to cater to these needs. Because today, you're going to define a research and development of solar in a very blind space. You do not know what the actual utilization at the end use is. We have not created, see, any other utilization of solar came through the space technology. That's how it were. But anything else came because there was a business coming up and then you had constant R&D that was happening. Until and unless the youth today, we are not going to happen. And automatically, I think there's going to be a lot of private money into this. And I think, not sounding cynical here, but I would rather have private initiatives for research and development where government creates the ecosystem of policies rather than the government itself putting in monetary benefits for research. But for that, we need to have more and more business models and ecosystems creation before I would jump into that R&D, because today there's enough technologies to prove that can be done today in the sustainable energy area.
Good evening, sir. My name is Sri Lakshmi Todavarapu. I am from TAPME. One major apprehension one has about social entrepreneurship is the resistance to change from the rural India itself or the poor. I don't know if this is a myth or reality. I want to check if this is a myth, and if it is real, how do you tackle it?
What do you think I'll answer? No, the question is, the challenge, I would say, is not from the rural India. The challenge is from parents. The challenge is from parents to say to the young boy and girl, mat karo, you will not get a boy or girl to get married to. The challenge is today from our family, don't do social. I mean, a lot of confusion in our parents' generation or in my own generation is social entrepreneurship means social work, you do it after 60 years. The myth, it's a complete myth that there's a resistance from rural India. Why should it be a resistance from rural India? The resistance will come only when you are not able to relate to them or they are able to relate to you. So spend your time so that people start relating. I mean, giving my personal example, the fear that I had when I first came back from the United States in 92 was whether the rural people would take me as one. And that's why I purposely went to Sri Lanka, because I didn't know the local language. Once you don't know the local language, they treat you at the same level. The question is, how do you learn to test yourself? Until and unless the auto rickshaw driver does not feel that you are another auto rickshaw driver, you have not graduated to that level. You can never do a proper survey. So once you immerse yourself and the rural people or any other poor start thinking that he or she is actually working with me and you are actually taking those people as partners, not just market where you want to sell, you'll see a changed perception. We in the 17 years have not absolutely found any resistance. My own resistance was in from getting youngsters and the parents of the youngsters coming and saying, what is the salary, because he needs to get married next month. So that's, it's a myth.
Good afternoon, sir.
Last question, please.
Sir, I'm Aditya from TAPME. There's a, so like what I understand from what you said, the degree and science has its own limitations. It is the skill of a person that will decide what best benefit he can give back to the society. So as you have, you find there's a disconnect between an MBA after graduation when he goes into the market or the job place. So at the end of 2 years, what should be a take-up in terms of the skills, skill sets that we can actually apply to, you know, better the place which we work?
In the danger of sitting here between your professors, I need to answer that, right? No, the question is, no, what you need to, I mean, in the sense is, don't, I mean, in the 2 years I classically see, I mean, myself, everything else, is like you are running, you are learning a textbook more with the end semester or an end exam in focus. And that's the fundamental mistake we all do, is this is the time where you, nobody knows you and you hardly have any money. This is the best time where you actually can gain most of the, and you're not married, no pressures, external pressures, call up your father, you know, get your money tomorrow. That's the best time to actually gain knowledge, free thought processes with no tension except if you have another love life. But the question is, it's you have a free, I mean, when you go into a textbook, it's not only what the professors gave you the textbook, but go deeper into, okay, what are the other methods? Go, what are the other models? Can I challenge the class, my classmates? How can I either, this is the best 2 years to in fact gain deeper knowledge, just sticking to my exams. And I think that's where most of us make the mistake of not studying about the ecosystem, but only relying on the textbooks. I think that's what I would, so that once you go down, you're at least little ready of knowing what the ecosystem is, and then you jump into practicality.
Well, my God, I mean, whatever you said, I remember telling my son, and you know what he said? Dad, age is catching up with you. Thank you, Dr. Hande, for that enlightening session. I hope your speech and the question answer session have stirred at least a few hearts to take up social entrepreneurial role, rather than joining the bandwagon of job seekers. Thank you very much for that wonderful interaction. It's my privilege now to propose the word of thanks. First and foremost, I sincerely thank Dr. Harish Hande, Managing Director of Selco Solar Light, for having taken out time amid a busy schedule to be with us today. Dr. Hande. Dr. Hande, you have made this day a memorable one for us. Thank you very much. I thank Dr. H.S. Ballal, Pro-Chancellor, Manipal University, who, despite a very heavy work schedule, readily agreed to be with us and chair this function. Sir, thank you very much for your kind gesture. I thank Dr. Shantaram, member of our TAPMI Trust and Governing Council, for being with us on this occasion. Thank you very much, sir. I thank the dignitaries of the dais who have graced this occasion by their august presence during this. Thank you very much for coming here, sirs. I thank the members of the press for being with us today to cover this event. I sincerely appreciate your support. Thank you very much. I thank the faculty and students of other institutions in and around Manipal who have made it to this event. Thank you very much. I thank the other members of public who have graced this occasion by their presence today. I thank the faculty, the staff, and the students of TAPMI who organized this event with meticulous care and concern for details. Thank you very much. Finally, I thank the Hotel Fortune in Valley View for providing us the necessary infrastructural support. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise while the chief guest exits the hall. Thank you very much.